Hi friends, Happy New Year. In this video, I'm going to show you how we can create this CSS animation. I thought of creating a CSS animation for this new year, and I have seen some of the cool CSS effects in some websites, and this is a combination of couple of those CSS effects. Okay, let's start. First, let me create a HTML file. In that, let me add a style.css file. And in the CSS file, let me add an universal reset code to reset my browser default styles. Also, I'm going to use two Google fonts. So I'm going to import those fonts. And I want a black background. I don't want to have a scroll bar. And so let me set overflow hidden and height 100 VH. Okay, first let's start with the message. Let me add that in the HTML. And in CSS, let me add width 100%, this font family, 100 pixel font size, font weight bolder, a nice color, and text align center. And so we can see this. Let me add position absolute to position this. Let me give top 50%. And so it is moved here. Let me animate this. First, I should not show this. And after a few seconds, I need to show this. And so, let me add opacity 0 and an animation, which is going to execute after 2 seconds. Let me define the keyframes for this animation. At 0%, opacity is 0. And at 100%, opacity is 1. Okay, now I need to move this from bottom to top. And so, let me add margin top 0 pixel here and margin top minus 200 pixel here. And so, it appears to be moving from bottom to top. Okay, let me add the year. Let me add a div for that. Actually, I wanted to split the characters inside year. And I wanted to split it like first 3 characters separately and the last one separately. Also, I want to access each character separately to apply different colors finally. And so, let me create a span first. Inside that, let me create 3 spans for each character. Let me add unique class names to each. And one more span outside to have the last character. For that, let me add the class as bold. Now, we will not see anything because the color of the font is black. But if I drag here, we can see. So, first, let me add a white color to each class. Now we can see this. Let's add some styles to increase the size. I'm going to use this font. Okay, let me add a letter spacing so that it looks good. Now I can position it somewhere below this text. For that, let me add position absolute, top 450 pixel, width 100% and text align center. And I need to separate this last character which is going to move to the top. For that, let me add position absolute, top 0% and an animation. For that animation, I'm going to move from top 0% to top minus 250%. Okay, it looks good. But as we have separated this and positioned absolutely, our entire ear is not in center. So I need to move that little left. So let me add a new class to this span and add a margin right of 100 pixel. Okay, I need to adjust this last character as well. For that, let me add margin left minus 80 pixel. Now looks good. Let me add the new character. For that, let me add a span outside of this. I'm going to add a class so that I can add a separate color finally. And then, let me add another class to position this. First, it should not be shown. And then, it should come from the right. For that, let me add position absolute and right minus 100 pixel. Also, an animation. For this animation, initially it is going to be right minus 100 pixel. And after a certain percentage, it is going to be right 635 pixel. And there it should wait for some time, so that the old character will be removed and then it should occupy the position of old character, which is going to be right 735 pixel. I have done some trial and error approach to find these values. The timings are not correct. This message should wait for the other animations to complete. So let me increase the timer. Now that is okay. And this old character animation should wait for the new character animation. So let me adjust those timers as well. Looks good. Let's add our balloon. For that, let me add a div, and for that div, let me add width 100 pixel and height 100 pixel and border radius 50%, so that it appears to be a circle. Let me add a background color of red so that we can see this. Let me increase the height so that it appears to be an oval balloon. Okay, now let me add a white color string. For that, let me use pseudo element after. Here, let me add a content which is going to be an empty string and width 4 pixel, height 100 pixel and background color white. I need to position this relative to the balloon. And so let me add position absolute to balloon. And here, let me add position absolute left 50%. And I need to add a margin left of minus 2 pixel to bring it to the center of the balloon and bottom minus 100 pixel. So now the string is ready. Let me also add this CSS to add a knot so that the balloon looks more realistic. Here I am using border style, color and width, and then I am positioning that so that we can see this. Let me add a margin left of minus 10 pixel. Okay, looks good. Our balloon is ready. Let's position that balloon. I am going to give top 50% and right 0%. Now the balloon comes here. I need to position that such that the string end should touch this character. For that, let me give a margin top of minus 285 pixel. Okay, now it is good. Let's add the animation. Our balloon animation should match the new character animation. So let me copy this. Okay. I'm going to tweak this so that the balloon leaves the new character and picks the old character. Okay, let's initially hide the balloon outside the viewport. Good. Now the balloon has to move along with the old character. For that, let me add top 50% here and then top minus 200% here. Let's see. Some of the timings are not correct. Let me adjust them. It is perfect now. Let's add some colors to these characters once the new character joins. For that, let me add a new animation. For that animation, let me change the color from white to some color. Okay, I need to adjust the timings. This is good. Let me add the colors to other characters as well. Last one is still white because we need to add the color here as well. Okay, this time it is giving a different effect. Let it be. Finally, let's add some fireworks effect. First, let me add a div for firework. And then inside that, let me create few divs with classes cracker. I'm going to add an ID to this. For the firework div, let me add position relative and let me position the cracker div. For that, let me give position absolute width 4 pixel and height 80 pixel. And I'm going to use the pseudo element before to add a background color, height, and let me position it so that it appears to be an explosion. Also, let me rotate each div to a certain degree and let me translate in the direction of Y. Let me give minus 15 pixel. And then let me add an animation which is going to run infinitely. For that keyframe, let me slowly change the top from 100% to minus 50%. Okay, so that we can see this. Let me position this firework div. Let me use transform origin property to change the point in which the transformation is applied. That means I'm inverting the way it is exploding. Let me also use overflow hidden so that we get a more realistic effect. And let me copy this div two more times. Let me change the IDs and then let me change each one's position. Also, let me use transform to change the scale of each one so that one appears big and the other appears small. Okay, everything looks good. We just need to delay this animation. For that, let me add a opacity 0 to this firework class and an animation. Inside this keyframes, I'm changing the opacity from 0 to 1. And so we can see this. Let me correct this timer as well. Now looks good. Hope you enjoyed this video. If you want this code, you can get it from the GitHub repo. The link is in the description. Please like this video, subscribe to my channel, and support me. Thank you. Bye.